Hello and welcome to my talk entitled Extracting and Leveraging Nodule Features with Line Painting for Local Feature Augmentation, which refers to a novel augmentation method for image classification. Lung cancer is one of the most frequent cancer types worldwide. In 2019, over 228,000 new cases and over 140,000 estimated deaths are predicted in the US alone. The overall 5-year survival rate is approximately 70% for people with stage 1A or 1B and 50% for people with stage 2A or 2B non-small lung cancers. An early detection of lung cancer is therefore necessary. Automated systems are developed to diagnose such abnormalities. For example, the nodules in chest X-ray images where we are focusing in this work. However, a tremendous amount of nodule data is typically needed to compete with such radiologist performance. State-of-the-art augmentation methods are often implemented. However, they are hardly improving the nodule classification performance. There are several drawbacks of the current state-of-the-art augmentation techniques. The current techniques are all applied globally on the full image. For example, you can rotate the full image in a certain degree. Those global modifications limit the degree of freedom to change the image. As we are working with nodules, which are very small abnormalities with less than or equal to 30 millimeters in diameter, the relevant features for nodule classification are only present locally on a very small fraction of the image. Therefore, we present in this work a novel augmentation technique to access those local features in the image, which contributes to the glass prediction and allows us to expand the augmentation space. We are focusing on two different data sets in this work. The first one is the chest X-ray 14 data set, and the second one the JSRT data set. Together, we can use 112,367 frontal chest X-ray images, and 6,485 of them are nodule images. For our classification purposes, we split this big data set into 70% for training, 10% for validation, and 20% for testing. We make sure that there is no patient overlap between the splits. In this slide, we explain local feature augmentation, our proposed augmentation technique to improve the performance on nodule classification based on chest X-ray images. The whole pipeline can be split into two parts. On the left-hand side, we see the nodule retrieval. It works with a patch inpainting network. Therefore, several nodule patches are necessary, extracted out of the nodule images. The nodule patches are overlaid with masks and fed into the inpainting network. The prediction should lead to realistic looking background tissue without the nodule. After that, the output is subtracted with the original nodule images, including a fine-tuning process leads to the nodule features, which can be seen in the middle. A collection of several nodule features lead to the local feature augmentation. Therefore, we can, for example, displace the nodules and do further modifications on the local patch to augment the image. Afterwards, the nodule classifier can be retrained. For the image inpainting network, we use a common context encoder to generate realistic looking patches. In the image, you can see such context encoder. The input is a patch, including a mask in the middle. We have an encoder and we have a decoder, which leads to the output prediction. Two different losses will be used to train this network. First of all, the reconstruction loss, and the second is the adversarial loss with an additional discriminator network.
Once the image inpainting network is trained,
we can retrieve the nodule features. We can retrieve the nodule features with the following equation. Therefore, we just subtract the output of the image in painting network with the original image patch. Afterwards, we apply some fine tuning to remove possible noise, which may be included after the retrieval process. Therefore, we use the bilateral filter with a filter size of 3, and we also truncate all negative values to 0, as pixels with nodules are brighter than without nodules. Here you can see some qualitative evaluation. In the first row, you can see the original patches, including the nodule, which is visible on 5 different examples. The second row describes the output of the image in painting network. And the last row at the very bottom, we can see the retrieval process, including the explained fine tuning. We furthermore show attention maps here to check qualitatively the performance of both the in-painting network and the classification network. Each patch, each possible patch in the chest X-ray images is in-painted sequentially and fed into the classification network. The prediction of the classification network is visualized as a tension in the image at the corresponding position. You can see then the patch, including the nodule, is in-painted. The output is therefore replaced and fed into the classification network. And the classification network immediately shows a very low prediction, which can be seen at the corresponding position. The existing nodule collections may lead to many different ideas. We are focusing on nodule classification. In general, we defined three different contributions. The first one is the insert the nodule features in non-nodule images with a certain probability P to create more positive images and to deal with the unbalancing problems in the data sets. The second one, we displace the nodule features at a random lung positions with the help of the lung segmentation masks. And the last one, we apply random rotation of the nodule features from 0 to 360 degrees. With the explained augmentation approach, we can retrain the classification network. We can see here the quantitative evaluation. We compare between the baseline model, which is a classification network trained without any augmentation, standard augmentation, which means we applied random rotation between minus 15 and 15 degrees and horizontal flipping, and our explained local feature augmentation. We evaluated on different training set sizes, and we conducted each experiment 3 times to show mean and standard deviation. On all experiments, we can see that the standard augmentation slightly improves the performance compared to the baseline. However, our local feature augmentation significantly improves on all different training data sets. To conclude my talk, we overall developed a novel augmentation technique by applying the modifications locally and not globally in the image. We trained a stable image in painting network to retrieve the nodule features for this augmentation process. We also showed significant improvement of nodule classification, including the proposed local feature augmentation technique compared to a given baseline or standard state-of-the-art augmentation techniques. As an outlook, we can also expand this approach to deal with other local abnormalities, for example, masses. We can also expand the approach to deal with other modalities and also three-dimensional data, for example, lung CT images. Thank you very much for listening.